Good morning. Welcome again in biology class. Children, today we are going to start vegetative propagation in plants. Vegetative propagation is the asexual reproduction in plants, and in this, children, will any part of the parent plant like root, stem, leaf or bud can propagate and give rise to new plant. Now, these structures are known as vegetative propagules. Now, these vegetative propagules, they are found in several aquatic and terrestrial plants of angiosperms. Now, there are several methods of vegetative reproduction. Now, these can be done by roots, by subaerial stem, by underground stem, by aerial stem, by leaf buds, bulbils, turions, and artificial propagation is there. So, let's start with the vegetative propagation by roots. In this type of reproduction, children, the plants bud bears tuberous roots, and these roots, they develop into a new plant. Now, for example, in sweet potato, dahlia and moraya, these buds, they have the aerial shoots and they produce new plants, and these plants, they have tuberous roots and they give rise to new plants from these tuberous roots. As you see in this diagram, children, these are the tuberous roots of sweet potato, dahlia and dalbergia. See here, and these tuberous roots, their main function is to store the food, because new plants are coming out from these roots. That is why they store food, and from these plants, new plants arises. Okay. So next is vegetative propagation by subaerial stems, like in lawn grass, dhub, then oxalis and hydrocotyle. These stem, they goes along the surface of the soil, and the nodes, they bear the leaves with axillary buds. Now these axillary buds, they give rise to adventitious roots and shoots upwards. So these nodes, the new plants arise from these nodes. Now such stems, they are known as runners. When new plants formed or established, the runners decays. Suckers, like in mint, chrysanthemum and pineapple, the subaerial stems are known as suckers. Now these suckers, they arise close to the ground and they give rise to a new plant. By stolen nectars, the subaerial stem strawberry, blackberry and colocasia, they are known as stolen. Now these stolen, they arise from lateral branches from the underground base of aerial shoot, and they grow horizontally in the soil, and then they develop into new aerial shoots from their tip. Now after that, each aerial shoot develops adventitious roots and they give rise to a new plant. Number fourth is offset. Now offset is a short and thick runner-like subaerial stem which grows in all directions from the parent stem, like in Pistia and Iconia, the water hyacinth. Now what is the water hyacinth, children? It is one of the fastest growing weeds in standing water, and it floats in water with the help of spongy and inflated petiole of leaves. Now these are introduced in India for its broad and attractive leaves and showy flowers, but they are very difficult to eradicate these water hyacinth from the water. Next, see here, subaerial stems of runner, then subaerial, then sucker, then mint, stolen and water hyacinth are offset. Okay, so as you see, they are growing on the surface of the ground, and from this surface, adventitious roots arises, and from these nodal regions, there are new plants are growing up. Then here in mint, suckers are there. Some part of the plant, it grows underground, and then adventitious roots arise, and from that part, apical bud and new shoot is coming out. So here see the what I said, root develops at the part and it grows to some distance and then again their roots develop and new plant is formed. So vegetative reproduction by underground stem. So these vegetative reproduction which is done by underground stem, they are in potato, sugarcane, banana, ginger, turmeric, onion and bore and etc. Now these underground stem, they help in vegetative reproduction and also in pollination. They include stem tuber, rhizome, bulbs, then corm. Now what are stem tubers, children? Now these stem tubers, they are underground storage organs and they are swollen with stored food. As I told you earlier also, why they look like tuberous are because they store food in it and they are produced at the tips of underground stem like in potato. Now these potato, they have eyes on their nose and these eyes, they grow into a new plant for the new growing season. Next come is rhizome. Rhizome is horizontally growing underground stem like in ginger, turmeric, and it also stores food in it and buds and adventitious roots, they arise from the part of rhizome and then these form a new plant. Then what are bulbs? As you see, bulbs of onion, tulip and daffodil, they are condensed underground shoot children. Now these bulbs, they have very short disc-like stem and they are also fleshy in nature because of the food in it. And in between these leaves, one or more terminal buds are there which grows into a new plant. So see here, vegetative propagation by underground stem. This is the root tube of potato. Now see, the eyes are here and from these eyes, new shoot will grow. These are the rhizome of ginger and scale leaves are there and at the nodal region, adventitious bud arises and from these adventitious buds, new plants will grow. Now here see the bulb of onion and in between these scale leaves, there are small buds. Now these, from these buds, new plant arises. Next is the corm. Okay, now this, what about the corm? Now the corm of gladiolus and coracas, they have basal swollen stem and scale leaves, they are remain of foliage leaves. Now they have buds for vegetative propagation. So here see corm, these buds are there and these buds, they help in the vegetative propagation. Now vegetative propagation by aerial stems. See here. So aerial modified stems of opuntia and some other plants, they develop into a new plant when stem segments fall on the ground. Now vegetative propagation by leaf buds, they are very common like bryophyllum, begonia. So leaf margins, they have small plants in it, they have adventitious buds and these notches, these adventitious buds, they give rise to new plant from these leaf. Now vegetative propagation by flower buds or bulbils. Then Dioxyrhiza agave and globa, special fleshy floral buds, they are known as bulbils, are present on the stem of the plant. Now they occur, they array as an inflorescence and these inflorescences, they grow into a new plant when the mother plant shed. The vegetative propagation by turions, like in aquatic plants like Potamogeton and Utricularia, fleshy floral buds develop from vegetative propagation and pollination also. Now methods of artificial or man-made vegetative propagation. So children, Till now we have studied the vegetative, natural vegetative propagation, but artificial vegetative propagation is also there. And in this artificial vegetative propagation, horticulturists use some special methods, so like cutting, layering, grafting or guti for fast multiplication of desired varieties of ornamental plants and fruit trees. So why they are important? Because from this type of propagation we get number of varieties of plant and the yield for these plant is also increases. So number one is cutting. Now in this method, children, like these methods, they are followed in rows or channel row stems. So in this type of cutting, oblique cut is done in the stem about 20 centimeters to a centimeter, and these stem they have at least two nodes and one internodes. Now rooting hormones are introduced at the end of each cutting and then it is planted into the moist soil. Now these cutting, they develop adventitious roots and shoots from roots and nodes and they grow into new plant. Now these are very common in rose, foliage, grapes, sugarcane, China rose, lemon, drumstick and bougainvillea. So here see the vegetative propagation by stem cutting in rose. Okay, so here is the cutting, stem cutting is there and we have taken two nodes and one internode, and from these the adventitious roots arises and they develop into a new plant. Next is grafting. Now grafting, it is the method of developing a superior plant by joining the shoot of a superior high yielding plant and the root system of the same species of the plant. Now these particular are carried out in dicot plants like mango, guava, apple, citrus, pear, and in this method root portion of one stem is taken and that is known as stalk, while the stem portion is taken from the other plant which is known as shion. Now the stem, the stalk which is taken from a plant, it should be disease resistant and it has a deep root system for absorbing water and minerals. Now the shion is from the plant which yields better quality of fruits and it can be done by following methods. Now how this grafting can be done? Number one is whip grafting or tongue grafting. Now children, in this grafting, stalk and shion, they are cut at this of the same diameter and they are obliquely cut. Okay, oblique cutting is there and they are placed end to end in that manner that the cambium of the two stems, they are in close contact. Now the stem of stalk is cut 20 to 30 centimeters above the ground. Now leaves and buds, they are removed from this part and both stalk and shion, they are bound firmly with the help of a thread or a tough thread or a tape, and again they are covered with a grafting wax to avoid any infection like bacterial infection. Okay, then they are leave as and after some time roots arises and they develop into a new plant. Number two is cleft grafting or the wedge grafting. In this cleft grafting, V shape is made in the stalk and wedge shaped cut is made in shion, and this shion is inserted in the cleft part or the cut part of the stalk and then they are tied together. Now crown grafting, again in crown grafting, more than one shions they are grafted on one stalk by wedge grafting. Now in wedge graft, in a crown grafting, children, shions they are narrow and stalk they are wide. Now bud grafting is there or the budding. Now in this method, a single bud, they are taken with the living tissues and they are made incisions in the stalk. Now budding is usually done in rainy seasons because in rainy season, children, lot of moisture is there, so there may be less chances of drying up these buds. Now this budding is a grafting is generally done in rose, apple and peach plant. Number fifth is approach grafting. Now in approach grafting, children, it is taken out in two independently growing plants. Now the shoot of each plant, they are cut at the same level and they are sliced sideways to expose near about 2.5 to 5.0 centimeter area at the same level. Now these shoots, again they are tied together at the region of cut, and once this grafting is done, the stalk is cut above the graft and scion is cut below the graft. So here there are several methods of grafting. Now this one is the tongue grafting, then whip grafting, then crown grafting is here, then bud grafting and approach grafting. So here see, this is cleft and this is wedge. Okay, stalk and scion. Stalk and scion. Several clefts are made in the stalk and many scions are inserted in this single stalk. Then there is a cut in this particular branch or the stem and bud is introduced and then it is tied together and it develops into a new plant. Then approach grafting is there. Two plants are taken over here, one and two, and then they are tied together. Cuts are made here and they are tied together. After developing some roots, then these are cut from the above. This stalk is cut from the above and then this particular scion is cut from the below and then they are forming a new plant. So next is layering. Now layering, it is the method of producing roots on stem while it is still attached to the parent plant. That means this method is done when the parent particular roots, they are attached to the parent plant. Now they are done by two methods, mound layering and aerial layering. And in mound layering, children, lower branch is bent to the ground and it is covered with moist soil. Now after some time, adventitious roots, they develop from the buried part and these are developed into a new stem or a new plant. In aerial layering or the guti, it is used in orange, guava, lemon, lychee, and they have thick branches which cannot be bent. So about an inch of bark is cut or they are removed from the stem and they are covered with moist grafts with polythene, which are wrapped in polythene sheet. When adventitious roots arises, a stem is kept below and level of roots are planted.